We're recounting our date last night. We went and had sushi.
We had a date last night.
We're adults.
It's almost like time for self, except for then we'd have to hit ourselves.
I wasn't asleep till like 10:30.
You madman.
Crazy. Whew, I'm like drinking caffeine at BYU.
We've been obsessed with sushi ever since that piece yesterday about that sushi restaurant down in Taylorsville.
Yes.
It's all we could think about all day is like sushi.
So we went and did it. Welcome, it's Todd and Erin Morning Stream on GetPartDaily.com. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Good morning, everybody on Facebook. Yes, I know sushi is delicious. I'm with you. Hi, Marianne. How are you, sweetheart? Let's go to the Morning Mountain Cam. It's brought to you by Black Diamond Experts, Electric Plumbing, Heating, and Air. It's dark. That's pretty much all we can see.
This
right
is pretty
now.
Much it. The rest of the year is going to be darker and
darker. It's darker and darker and darker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, moving on, though. Really interesting. We're going to tell you about the Love Army. Who's hanging around on Capitol Hill for the Equifax hearings? Who's even cracking up the senators?
And who's hanging from a tree?
That one was different.
And Holiday.
And an update on the mad pooper.
I know.
Can you imagine that's going to be like your legacy? This semi-normal looking woman, that will be her legacy.
No. There's a major issue and a major development in the story.
I did not know that.
Yes. The cops are involved. All right, you want to talk about the Love Army.
Well, our entire goal right now is just the fact that what good can we find coming out of Las Vegas? Because it's so inexpressibly awful that the only thing you can do is try to focus on what have we done that's redeemed some of the evil in the world. And the Love Army are just absolutely amazing. It's the Las Vegas Victims Fund. It started out with the Clark County Commission Chair, Steve Sisolak. He raised $8.42 million. Interestingly, $3 million of that came from MGM Resorts, which was nice.
Right.
The Oakland Raiders donated $50,000, mm-hmm. which I thought was an interesting combination. Mm-hmm. GoFundMe went to the Love Army, though, and they ended up raising another $3.5 million. And that was just sort of like this guy who literally put up a piece of paper. He was in a restaurant, and he goes, I just think we should all be involved.
Do it.
And then, like, 3.5 million later, he's like,
okay.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You really got involved.
It was really, I mean, I don't know. It was really touching. Jonathan Smith, the one you remember who was shot in the neck,
mm-hmm.
and he saved over 30 people.
Dragged him under the stage.
His sister-in-law raised $49,000 to raise money for medical expenses for him. I'm very happy about.
A lot of this money is going to go to that. A lot of this money is going to go to taking care of the medical bills and stuff, which even if you're slightly wounded, and let's say slightly wounded, and that was stupid, if you're wounded and you went to the hospital and you didn't have insurance,
yeah,
what are you going to do? And so this is going to step in and do that, so a lot of people don't end up going bankrupt, and they can deal with the challenge they already have.
Well, I'm sure Clark County, the city of Vegas, would have taken care of it anyway. And I'm sure there's some sort of federal funding. But this is, I mean, if you're talking about long range or rehabilitation, and you're at missed costs, like if your family depends on you,
not working.
It's a big deal. Mm-hmm. Now, here's something that we can do. We talked about this earlier in the week when someone from the Red Cross had contacted us and said, I bet you're going to talk about this. Here's something you can do, and we'd mentioned you can give blood. Now, we're the next closest supply line to Las Vegas. They're having a big blood drive at St. Olaf Catholic Church in Bountiful on Saturday. If you get a chance and you can stop by, they're going to be there starting at 8 a.m. They're going through most of the day. You can stop by and donate blood. They would be thrilled to have you. It's an easy thing to do, and usually on Saturday, more of us might have a little bit more time to sit down for an hour and get it taken care of. So
you can also go to online to the Red Cross, and they'll tell you where a center is near you,
mm-hmm.
and they can call and see how busy they are. Because, and I'm not saying this, don't listen to this, they've actually had to turn some people away in other states because they're so busy. And
in Vegas,
they said it's been crazy, and people are just waiting out the door. And we say, I don't know if we can, they don't leave. They stay in line.
I think that's amazing. No, it's
and so
important.
Storage for the things, and they're like, we are thanking you very much, but... So don't forget what I just said. Just
wow,
go.
That was kind of a downer. What was the point of that?
I just couldn't
stop it. Hey, here's
a
chance. Don't do it, though.
It was coming out of my face, and I couldn't stop it.
They need your help.
I spoke
to someone as of yesterday.
They don't
need donations.
I'm a moron.
So please, do not hesitate, no matter what my
don't
husband just said to me.
Don't listen to Todd.
At all. They need you, so please
That's
do.
My best advice to you
donate.
Is to listen. to me.
And this is also a really cool chance. I had a chance to talk to one of our listeners, and we'd done this a couple of years ago. I can't remember what the disaster was when we were on the radio. And she had been listening to us, and she heard us talk about the Red Cross disaster volunteers. Mm-hmm. She went, that's really interesting. And she works retail, so she thought, okay, I could work with my boss, and
right.
he would give me time off during disaster times. So she went and she trained, and she said, this has changed my entire life. It's changed my entire life and how I look at the world. Mm-hmm. She's been to two different third world countries for disasters. Wow. She's gone to all these places for grief counseling. She said, I can't tell you what it's done for me, because she checks back with us about every year just to say right. thank you for even bringing it up. If that's something you think that you want in your life, if that, you want that kind of change, it's an incredible thing, and it could be something as simple as just helping with house fires here in Utah to ending up in Guatemala with an earthquake.
I mean, and the guys here who cover the news and stuff, they know what this is about. They go and a house is burnt, and then families are displaced, and
sitting on the gutter staring.
Red Cross
space,
shows up, and they start with a blanket and get housing and get food and get kids to bed, and they take care of stuff, and that's like real local and stuff, and then Guatemala. And places like that are open.
But you shouldn't go to Guatemala.
The
There's probably a line.
There's a line of people helping people there. I'm so sorry.
I love you.
I meant to say it like, look how well it's working. And in Vegas, they're actually turning people away. And it sounded like a positive thing, but I put it on the back of my hand and I slapped you with it. And I'm sorry. Is that enough?
That was pretty good.
Okay.
All right, moving on to Equifax, because I hate them so much that I can't
Donate
really
plug.
Breathe. I got to spend more time with that yesterday. We found out just 2 days ago that when the president of Equifax, who was being pressured out of his position, kind of mentioned on the way out the door, oh, there's another 2.5 million people that we didn't tell you about that was a part of the breach, sorry, and then left. Guess who's part of the 2.5 million people who we just found out five different credit cards were opened in our name. So thank you so much, Equifax. They're doing a hearing on Capitol Hill right now, and Congress is pretty much grilling them like, how could you have been this stupid? I mean, you have all of this power, this ridiculous amount of power in consumers' lives. How could you have been this dumb? But here's the best part. Even the senators were tweeting about this yesterday, and they were all trying to take pictures with their cameras, their phones, without looking like totally unprofessional. Right. There's a guy dressed up like Rich Uncle Pennybags. Do you remember from Monopoly? With the big hat?
Right, there he is with a mustache.
And he keeps showing up, and he'll just, like, twirl his mustache and keep leaning in and out.
Oh, that's so funny.
And all the congressmen are having a really hard time keeping their expression straight, because it's like he's just totally... I mean...
That is so funny.
Everyone needed a little bit of Rich Uncle Pennybags, so thank you, sir, for
Unfortunately,
you are.
When the CEO left, he had a parachute payment.
Really?
Oh.
Oh, thank God he won't suffer.
I don't know what it is, but it's usually something just to tick you off. It's like, you know, $80 million
Bazillion
or something.
Bazillion nine, and yeah.
Anyway, it's our money.
Thank heavens he'll be okay. So
we were worried.
We were all thinking
about
it.
We were really concerned about it.
At night with
yeah.
him. So that's good. All righty. Matt Pooper, tell me the update.
Colorado Springs. Remember 2 weeks ago, we started talking about a lady who was jogging by these people's houses, and the kids came and said, Mom, there's a woman pooping on her front yard. Da, 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 da. Lady goes, that can't be true. My kids must be drinking. And then she goes out in the front yard and she says, why are you...
My kids must be
why
drinking.
Are you pooping on my yard? Ew.
And this is a normal looking woman in jogging clothes who's even carrying toilet paper.
She stands up and she goes, I'm sorry, and then runs off. So the woman is thinking, maybe this is just some weird kind of event.
Like
and then
a prank.
Next week it happens again. They set up cameras and stuff like that. Actually had some pretty decent pictures, so I'm really surprised she didn't get caught. And now there was another update where she was spotted again in Colorado
Springs.
Actually,
she's in her fourth. I think she's already done her fourth poop, public poop.
There's an outcry from the Colorado Springs police, begging people to stop calling and asking questions about the defecating jogger, dubbed the Mad Pooper. It's clogging up their phone lines and their Facebook page. All people want to talk about is the pooper girl. And they say, please don't. We have other things to do, like solve murders. And
we're sorry that she's out there terrorizing the town with her turds, but...
terrorizing her towns with her turds.
Yeah, it's pretty sad.
That's nicely done,
sad
though.
Thing.
So stop calling them. We should just call them. We
because you've already started off the day in, like, the weirdest possible way, so why not?
Hey, you got any more information on the Mad Pooper? That'd just be funny.
Well, it's a weird story. No one can help themselves. All right, this is kind of cool. I'm very happy with Senator Hatch right now. Children's health insurance, this is a big deal. This is for children with families who are under a certain poverty level. And I don't think any one of us can argue that children should have the right to adequate medical care.
You vote against this,
Seriously, I mean, yeah. Anyway, so he was pushing the legislation through Capitol Hill the other day, Children's Health Insurance Program. It passed through all the committees, mainly because he kind of like ramrodded it, like, get moving, because everyone else is worried about, you know, the NFL and everything else. And he said, we're doing this now. And so it goes to the U.S. Senate floor today.
Nice.
But it's really important. He said this is crucial because kids who are already on CHIP, on the Children's Health Insurance Program, if they don't fix funding within the next, like...
It's over.
2 weeks.
Yeah.
It's all done, and nobody has coverage for anything. And if that happens, then it takes months and months and months to redistribute, reallocate, and reapply and do everything else they have to do.
So he's pushing through.
So he's, like, under this level of anxiety to get this done. So thank you so much for doing that. And it's always a very nice idea if you want to harass your senator and remind them that you think children should have adequate medical care.
Because you're a human being.
Because, you know, yeah. Anyway, so good for you, Senator Hatch, and terrorize them, please.
Information time.
All right, Daisy is in the Gephardt Daily Newsroom. She is brought to you by Fink and McGregor. Mortgage is made simple. If you go to fink-mcgregor.com, you will be amazed at the array of mortgage options. Also, it's brought to you by Kuwahara's Corn Maze and Pumpkin Patch. By the way, this is free, and this is like one of those perfect Pinterest photo op moments. Already open at 7th West and 122 South in Draper. And of course, also by Black Diamond Experts. Experts in electric, plumbing, heating, and air. It's blackdiamondexpert.com. Good morning, Daisy.
Thanks, Todd and Erin. Hello, everyone. Here's what's making headlines Thursday, October 5th on GephardtDaily.com. The Salt Lake County District Attorney's Office has ruled the officer involved shooting of a Salt Lake City man last summer justified. 50-year-old Patrick Harmon was riding his bicycle down State Street the night of August 13th when he was stopped by police for not having a tail light. During questioning, officers realized Harmon had outstanding felony warrants, including one for assault. When police tried to cuff him, Harmon took off, running just a few yards before turning toward the officers while holding a knife. One of the cops opened fire, shooting Harmon 3 times in the back. Harmon later died at a local hospital. The DA's office released body cam video, which they said was key in their decision to rule the shooting justified. A hot time in Cottonwood Heights Wednesday after a backhoe operator at the Public Works building accidentally broke a gas line and started a roaring fire. Police and firefighters responded to the scene near 6580 South 3000 East about 3 p.m. Crews closed roads and were able to knock down the fire by about 4:15. The backhoe operators suffered minor injuries, according to police reports, and did not require medical care. And former Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney has endorsed Provo Mayor John Curtis in the race to fill the 3rd congressional district seat vacated by Jason Chaffetz. Romney called Curtis a problem solver and said he would serve Utah well. Curtis will face Democrat Kathy Allen and Jim Bennett, son of former U.S. Senator Bob Bennett, who is running with the new United Utah Party on November 7th. And now to our Wasatch Front weather, where we'll see slightly higher temperatures prior to the approach of a cold front later this weekend. Temps will be in the upper 60s to the low 70s before the crap hits the proverbial punch bowl Saturday night into Sunday, and overnight lows will be in the 40s. That's all for now. For more local headlines 24/7, go to GephardtDaily.com. And Todd and Erin, back to you.
Okay, let me tell you why Todd and I have a list of people that we trust that's hanging on our refrigerator, and that, of course, Black Diamond Experts Electric, Plumbing, Heating, and Air are on the list. A couple of weeks ago, we took my car in to get some servicing at one of the dealerships, Jerry Seiner, and they told us, oh, you have this one thing that has to be fixed. It's going to cost $1,200. So we took the car instead to somebody we trusted, somebody that we've worked with for many, many years. They went, oh, no, your oil filter is just loose. I'm going to tighten that up, and there's nothing leaking. So the fix was basically an oil change. This is why it's really important to have somebody that you trust, because you could have somebody come into your house and go, oh yeah, your furnace is like cracked and stuff, and like, you're gonna know? Really? I wouldn't know. And then you would like end up spending thousands of dollars that you probably don't have. Or you could have somebody like Black Diamond Experts who will come in and say, yeah, there was a problem, let us help you, or no, I can just fix your filter and you're done. And, but it's nice to know who you can trust, and that's why Black Diamond is amazing at this stuff. And once again, because it's electric, plumbing, heating, and air, that encompasses pretty much your entire house. Oh, they have a brand new shop open in Ogden now, so it's even more convenient for you. 24-hour service, by the way, for emergencies, so just go to blackdiamondexperts.com.
All right, so tell me something good. Someone is building things for people.
I love this.
Is it a secret thing?
Well, I lived in Virginia for a long time, and they had this squirrely thing with mailboxes.
Like what?
And I remember that they would only have them like on one side of the road, so you would have to like cross over to the other side, especially in the rural areas.
It makes it quicker.
Yeah.
For the mail person.
But for very, very busy streets, it's an issue. Parents are always nervous about their kids.
Oh, crossing the street, right.
Yeah, and so there was a very nice lady who had one of those problems, this Linda Tennant.
Uh-huh.
She's blind, and she would go out, and she would just be terrified, but she
would
very
cross
determined
the street.
To be independent. And,
she'd go across the street, she'd get her mail.
Yeah, and so, but when you're talking about a busy street,
right.
And you have... you're sightless, it's an issue.
Right.
It's really scary. Well, there was a neighbor who noticed that and realized how intense that was for her and called a friend of theirs. He said, you're handy. Is this something you could do?
Right.
And it's Wesley Benton. He's owner of Benton Home Improvement. He went, yeah, I can do that. So he shows up, and it's adorable. He took a look at it. He was trying to figure out what to do, and he created an easy access mailbox, got it installed so that the mail actually goes directly to right in front of her house. It's still legal. The post office still uses it. And she was genuinely shocked. She goes, could I give you a hug for this? And he said, that's fine. And she said, why did you do it? He said, well, my great-grandmother got hit by a car when she was crossing the street to get her mail. And he goes, I can't stand to think that that would happen to you.
So basically what he has is he has a mailbox that opens from the back as well, so she doesn't have to step off the curb.
Exactly.
And get into the street. Now I understand.
Isn't that clever?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It didn't take a lot.
But what a sweetheart.
To be a wonderful person.
Right?
Oh,
I know.
Donate blood, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier. There's no line.
All right, we want to thank you, by the way, for all the support that you've had for the morning stream. Do you realize we're coming up on 2 million views? We've only been doing this for less than 7 months.
7 months.
2 million views. Wow, you've got a high pain threshold.
Our work release program's almost over.
I know. Ankle monitoring bracelets are almost off.
Then we can go probation, and then the next thing you know, it's Tahitian Island. But we want to say thank you, and the best way you can think about is putting really good food in your face.
You know, we're going to buy your love, and it's one filet at a time. That's why Christopher's Prime Steakhouse is such a perfect thing.
Yummy.
If you haven't eaten there, it's basically going to turn you into a steak-loving zombie for the rest of your life. I'm sorry, because it's that good. But we're going to give you dinner for four, and all you have to do to enter is to simply make a comment on the show today. We're talking about Christopher's right now, so if we see a comment at this time, we're going to know you were watching and talking about Christopher's. That comment automatically enters you to win, and then we draw a winner on Friday. Now, you can do this at the Get Part Approved Facebook page, Get Part Daily Facebook page, or, of course, on the Todd and Erin Facebook page. So thank you.
All right, so you guys are Daisy and you are going to talk about what's coming up this weekend.
There is a movie coming out this weekend that has got massive electric buzz, and this is a follow-up to a classic, so you know the pressure.
I know, My Little Pony. It's going to be great.
All
right. Do I have to leave now?
Daisy's
right next. Back. Yeah, I'm
gone. Todd and Erin's Morning Stream, brought to you by Black Diamond Experts. Electric, plumbing, heating, and air conditioning. You'll be glad you called an expert. Fink & McGregor, mortgages made simple. Make sure you go to fink-mcgregor.com and try out their 4-minute mortgage program. It's incredibly easy to find out whether you qualify. The Todd and Erin Morning Stream is actually available anytime at gephardtdaily.com. Just click on the Todd and Erin page.
Did you know you can buy a house with a 600 credit score?
Really?
We have lenders, we have programs, stuff that's come up in the last couple years. 600.
Wouldn't you have to have like 50% down or something though?
Nope. 3.5%.
Where would you start the process on this?
Well, Fink & McGregor has a website, 4minutemortgage.com. Just go there, fill it out, up and running.
How long until you get back to us?
One business day. Whole thing takes about a month, start to finish.
Where do you get the down, though, if you're broke?
It can be a gift, family, relative, significant other, even your work.
Gift, huh?
Yeah.
You know what that makes me wish?
What?
Makes me wish I had friends with money.
We'll be right back.
No, I'll totally get you a pumpkin when I go to Coor Harbor today. We're going to go out and film there. So.
We're talking pumpkins. It's a very serious conversation.
Well, no, I'm just kind of stunned it wasn't that big a deal, because for like kids, this is like the holy grail. You get free candy. You dress up.
Yeah.
But for creepy Pinterest-inspired people like me, this is like everything.
I was just telling Erin that when I grew up in England, when I was little, I grew up in a small village and nobody even knew what Halloween was or what trick-or-treating was or anything
Guy
like
Fawkes
that.
Day, right?
Yes, bonfire night. Yeah, okay. Exactly.
But no free candy, just bonfires.
Well,
I like arson, but candy is, it seems like it's a crucial part of any good holiday.
I mean, because my mom's American, is she would like make us really great costumes and stuff. And
you will trick or treat.
Yeah, and we'd go round, but we'd have to explain to every person what, you know, they were like, what, trick or treat? What is this? And honestly, we ended up, someone gave us like a bunch of carrots. Not even supermarket carrots, like earthy carrots.
Oh,
and then
nice.
Someone else gave us this tiny little bunch of like, you know, grapes when they get kind of flat and old. Not flat, but kind of deflated.
They're almost raisins.
Yeah. And it was like, and they just didn't. And then we'd get like an opened bar of dairy milk with like four pieces. And we're like, that was like celebration time. So, you know, it was.
The toaster. Here's a toaster item. That's so sad. So you're standing there just fidgeting on the doorstep going, Mom.
Yeah, and then Mom would sort of explain, you either give us something or we do something bad to you. And they're like, oh, that doesn't seem like a great deal. So
I can see that would be an awkward exchange for you. Yeah.
I think now in England, Halloween, you know, it's got bigger, of course.
It has to be. There's free candy involved. Mm-hmm. Free.
Yeah. So I mean, what is wrong with that?
But you take it
quite seriously, don't you?
No. This is my big holiday. Mm-hmm. See, Christmas, that's for amateurs. Everybody decorates for Christmas. Mm. But Halloween has all the crucial components. You get to dress up.
Mm-hmm.
You get to be somebody else other than yourself.
Yes.
You get a buttload of free candy.
Yes.
You get to decorate all you like, and you don't have to buy any presents. You don't have to buy any potpourri for your boss's wife. You don't have to get any of the insincere fruit loaves for your neighbors. None of that crap.
Did you say insincere fruit loaves?
Yes.
Oh.
The insincere fruit loaves.
As opposed to the sincere ones.
Well, there's a couple of those, but not many, because fruit loaf, as it's known, really isn't a sincere piece of bakery goods.
That's true. Is there a downside to Halloween?
Not that I can see, no.
Okay.
We're starting with free candy, and we're working up from there. There's no downside to free candy. There's not.
Anyone not like Halloween? I'd like to hear from anyone that's
mention
like...
Mention it on Facebook if you think it's a terrible holiday, mm-hmm. but I would be troubled by you. Mm-hmm. But, mm-hmm. Oh, there is one guy we'll tell you about later.
He's troubled
by Halloween.
Yes.
Let's talk of happy things, though.
Lots
hanging from trees.
You know, I was thinking this morning when I was driving in, I was like, okay, this weekend, do something nice. It's been such a week.
I know, such a week.
And it's like, if you do have a bit of time off this weekend, maybe, you know, we have some suggestions for you. Go do something fun with the family. By yourself, friends, you know, but everyone needs a bit of a boost right now, don't they?
You know, that's the coolest thing, and they've actually talked about this, even in quantum physics, where they talk about the fact that you can alter the chemical and atomic balance of something by the negative and positive charges, and they mm-hmm. changed that to the concept of the world, in that even if we're at like 51% positive, even if we tip it just that much, where mm-hmm. you've done something kind, or mm-hmm. you wake up happier,
right.
or you try to be more meaningful for
right.
someone else, if you can just tip the balance into 51%, it changes mm-hmm. everything across the mm-hmm. the world, and that's pretty cool.
And I know, like, I've had the inclination this week a couple of times to be, when I've had plans, like, just... like inadvertently, it's like, oh no, I kind of, you know, I don't want to go out. I kind of want to stay home and, you know.
Then
I think when you do go out and like do stuff and see people, it can just be a bit of a cheer up, you know, which is good. Right now.
I think you're right. I love this one because it's really, my son Zach, he's still obsessed with trains, and so I'm thinking about taking him. It's included with admission or it's free for members down at Discovery Gateway, but on Saturday, they're doing something with the Utah Model Railroad Club, Operation Lifesaver, and the Lego Users Group. It's really cute. They have all these interactive train activities. They have boxcar races, locomotive races, a demolition derby. They have a little ride on train. Don't you love those? Even if I'm too big for it, I still want to write it.
Oh, my.
Don't you love them?
I feel like every boy in Utah is going to want to go to this.
Tell me that's not so cool.
Wow.
And they've got all kinds of different Lego combinations that you can do to create trains. Mm-hmm. And so it's going to be a lot of fun. So,
amazing.
Yeah, it's this Saturday, and it's 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. free for members, and it's included with admission.
Otherwise. At the Gateway. Mm-hmm. Super easy. Yeah. And then I've got two events for Saturday, so you can have like a great, busy,
Everybody likes yours the best. Because you have giveaways.
I have tickets.
So you're always the most popular here.
So roller derby doubleheader. You know I can't talk enough about roller derby.
Oh, yeah.
But this is a fun one. So it's at the Derby Depot that we've we've talked about before. It's 1415 West South, 1415 South, 700 West.
It's kind of like over the freeway from Walmart if you're thinking
exactly.
in that direction.
Yep. Yeah, and then you just hang a left. It's easy. You guys have been there.
Oh, yeah, many times.
Yeah, of course.
Until I embarrassed my sister because I was the screaming one.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Yeah. And this is, so it's a doubleheader. Quite cute because the first game kicks off at 6 and it's the kids. It's Wasatch Junior Roller Derby.
That cracks me up. How young can they start?
They can start pretty young. And the thing that's great is you go in and you're like, oh, sweet little girls, sweet little boys, ambling around the track. And then you get in there and they're like beating the out of each other and like, especially
children.
The little girls, you know,
oh my gosh.
And it's fun. It's really fun to watch. And then and then there are a couple, there's one that I used to love and her name, I think she still skates, but her name's Tiger Lily. And she's like, literally like as big as this, you know, she's like, you can't see, but like the height of this table.
Just tiny little buttercup.
Yeah. Oh. And but they're all like jazzy and cute and it's just sweet.
I know. There's just something about a small, adorable children in shoulder pads.
Yeah.
Knocking the crap out of
each
other.
Yeah. And then there's a there's the home team bout, which is Black Diamond Divas Hot Wheelers. So, you know, they're all, it's always a fun night. They have concessions, they have entertainment at halftime, that kind of thing.
I'm always genuinely astonished at what a family thing it is.
Oh, yeah.
Because you wouldn't picture roller derby as like the all-family event, but people are there with kids and babies and the nannies are screaming, kill them, kill them! It's really fun.
Yeah, and if you're... If you're adults, you can sit, you can bring blankets and sit right by the track, which is fun. And it's only $10, so that's like a whole evening of fun. We do have a couple of tickets to give away, like, comment, share.
On Facebook.
And it's just a fun, relaxed thing to do.
I love that.
And then this other thing, right? Your train event was 8 till 5 at the Gateway.
10 till 5, yeah.
10 till 5, sorry. And then we've got Locals Pro Sale, Not Your Dad's Ski Swap. This is at Pioneer Park, and it is 8 till 2.
Oh, okay. So you could slither in there and then nip right over to Discovery Gateway.
Yeah. So I think it's coinciding with the farmer's market, which it must be coming to an end.
I think
soon.
This might be the last weekend, if I'm right.
Right? Yeah. So that's definitely coming to the end.
We haven't even been
season.
Down this year. We've got to go down this Saturday.
I haven't been once.
I know. I feel so bad. What's wrong with us?
So many things.
We're not...
Start.
It won't even categorize, but you're completely correct.
Hang on. Let me look on page 27. Yes, does not attend farmer's market. Oh, dear. Oh, dear me.
Bad.
You know, I always envy those ladies that you see pictures of, and they've got, like, armfuls of gladioli and, like, a bag full of fresh leeks. I'm like...
I'm going to be making something with kale.
Yeah, really. Kale and leek flambé or whatever. Let's just face it, we are not those ladies.
I'm not that lady. No.
But so this is super cool. I guess it's organized by a professional athlete. And it's just, you can buy all your ski and boarding stuff for, you know, well under retail prices.
Wayne, if you have children, that is a big freaking deal.
Yes, because
outfitting Zach and Zoe is insane.
And it's expensive, you know,
and because, especially when they're little.
Yeah, and you can't just buy skis. You've got to buy the whole, you know, the hot goggles and poles and hats and gloves and all that. So this is a really good way of like going and just, you know, kitting your family out if you ski a lot in the winter. You know,
one thing that's kind of cool. I've seen these before, and they actually like readjust everything for you there, which really, really nice because that's a big deal.
It
all
is a big deal.
Bindings and clips and everything.
Yeah,
I wouldn't know how to do it.
Yeah,
so.
Do they what's it called when they, not polish, but like sharpen. Do they do that as well, where they, they'll sort of sharpen?
You wax the skis?
Yeah, and...
I don't think they really wax them, but resetting all the bindings and all the settings is a big thing.
Yeah, oh, totally.
Because that way you're not on your knees when it's 300 degrees below zero,
yes,
trying to get your kids booed into their...
Oh, yeah. God, which is a nightmare.
Yeah.
And then they're like, it's too tight.
Been there, yeah.
I actually used to teach children skiing.
Did you?
If you can believe that.
I can totally believe that about you.
It was awful.
The twins took ski lessons for years. I don't think I've skied. I skied backwards for like 5 years in a row. I don't think I can even remember how to ski.
Right, because you're just holding them going, snowplow, snowplow.
I know, you remember, I'm sure. Oh my God, when's the last time you actually faced down the hill when you had your skis on?
So, yeah, and the snow is coming, so go and get yourself, outfitted, and then when the snow comes and the resort's open, you're all set.
And don't think about the so many things that are wrong with Daisy and me.
No, don't. Just don't.
Oh, I have been waiting for this, and I know you were excited about it too. Blade Runner, the original Blade Runner, of course, back set in the 80s. Mm-hmm. Harrison Ford is back. Ryan Gosling is playing sort of like the gloomy, meaningful detective this time.
Yes.
This thing is a freaking barn burner. Have a look.
Every civilization was built off the back of a disposable workforce. But I can only make so many. Happy birthday.
See that?
So good.
Like insane buzz.
Yeah.
And all the premieres, everyone was saying you'll die.
Yes.
It's better than the original.
Yes.
It's better than they expected.
And people love the original. We were just saying it's not one of those ones that's like, oh, a sequel, cool. Like they've got a high bar.
Insanely high. I know, I'm so excited.
Oh,
are
so
you,
excited.
Are you and Jay going to go see it?
Yeah, we definitely are. Yeah, for sure. That's definitely part of our weekend.
I might have to be your third wheel then because Todd doesn't like science fiction.
Yeah, you can.
Can you believe I married a man who doesn't like science fiction?
I don't love science fiction, but Blade Runner.
It's Blade Runner.
What are you
going to say? It's Blade Runner. Okay, also coming out this weekend, another classic, as Todd has reminded us, it's My Little Pony.
I'm Princess Twilight Sparkle, and this is my home, Equestria. A land filled with magic, music.
Yeah. Whoa.
And most importantly, friendship. Life is perfect. I mean, what could possibly go wrong?
Yeah, it's My Little Pony. You know you're taking the kids. Daisy just said you're taking Zoe, and I'm like, yeah. I might have a drink first, but we're going.
Mm-hmm. That actually looks pretty awful, doesn't it? I mean, I'm sure not if you're six, but...
As a six-year-old, you're going to be the happiest child ever. And it's the mean pony princess queen lady. So, it's got to be good.
Could you just, deposit Zoe in in My Little Pony, kind of near to another mom, and then rush off and see Blade Runner?
We actually used to do that with my sisters. We'd all all of us would have to take one gaggle of children to a movie so that we're all not required to witness every children's movie.
Oh, okay.
But the rest of
them
are all older now, and I'm the only one stuck with the six-year-old now. And they're like, we're not helping you.
Yeah.
No, it's not going to happen. So there you go. All right, we have more news about My Little Pony, by the way, at the end of the show today, because there's a whole new thing you probably haven't heard about called bronies that we will be explaining to you.
Yes.
All right. Thank you, my beloved Daisy. You were wonderful.
Thank you.
I'm going to tell you about the vein clinic. I went there and visited this week, and I would just like to say I feel like I'm kind of an expert about varicose veins. Well, no, I'm just an expert apparently at growing them. I had one doctor tell me that I was a varicose vein factory, which is pretty much the case. It's pathetic. But this is the place that you go when you have problems like that, because everyone thinks, oh, it's just cosmetic. No. It's a big health issue. There's a ton of different problems, a ton of different issues. That's Angelina there. And she does an amazing job, especially with post-care, where she can get rid of scarring like you can't imagine. You can come out of this like your legs look the way they did before you had children and the ravages of age and cruelty. And all you have to do is go out for a consultation. They do a screening. Everything is in the same room. They'll totally relax you and make you feel good. It's in Riverton at 12523 South Creek Meadow Road. Easiest way is just to go to theveinclinic.com. Theveinclinic.com. And we'll be back next with the weirdest Halloween decoration ever. Mm-hmm.
We're brought to you this morning by Executive Transportation. Elegant service, professional style. Go to executiveutah.com. And All Utah Plumbing. Your home deserves the best. 24-hour emergency service at allutahplumbing.com. Did you know you can catch the Todd and Erin morning stream any time of the day or night on Facebook, YouTube, and SoundCloud, and GephardDaily.com?
Forget about the free corn maze.
Oh, when we go to the Kurahara pumpkin patch today, we have to pick up a little pumpkin for Daisy. Okay. She wants a little petite one, not like the rest of us who want one bigger than our head. She's like, give me a little tiny one.
Very good. Speaking of Halloween, in the news, there's been a house in Holiday that's got a decoration that people are kind of about.
And by the way, one particular site, news site, actually did the address, which I'm not sure is cool.
So I went there. Now, using my incredible video skills with my signature move of having my finger over part of the lens, here it is.
Okay,
see, there's my finger. That's my move right there.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay, so take a look.
Essentially, this is a guy hanging from the tree. Now,
it's Halloween.
And that's the only decoration. There's nothing around
it. That's on that side of the house.
Uh-huh.
That's like an empty lot next to the house.
So why would they do a hanging corpse on the empty lot next to their house?
Because it's a great tree.
Uh-huh.
All right, here's the discussion we had yesterday about this. First of all, creepy. Yes. When I think of hangings, I think the Wild West. I think of pirates and the Pirates of the Caribbean when they're going into the harbor and this says, warning to all pirates. That's what I think about.
Well,
I'm also aware of the...
Well, the neighbors had a lot of concern because that little pumpkin, orange pumpkin mask that was hastily added on is a new addition because the original head for the dummy was black. So the neighbors understandably went, this seems to me like an indication, a representation of a lynching, a lynching of an African-American. And they were concerned by by the look of that and the potential message it was sending. So over sushi last night, we talked about this for an hour and a half of what it's, the significance.
Now, I totally understand, having grown up during part of that era, what this, you know, of in the 60s and the activists and such in the South, and I totally understand there'd be an association with that. I totally get it.
And I've lived in the South for so long that maybe that's where that was my where my brain first went. But
right.
You see something like that there, it's like you know exactly what it means.
So once again, I think it depends on. It's not a racist thing. It's just a matter of if you have. I had a corpse in my front yard climbing out of a coffin.
Yeah, but we also had a full decorative array of.
You can't bring that into it.
But I think this is the deciding factor.
Maybe he just started.
Okay, the only improvement he's made to his Halloween decor since is adding the little orange pumpkin.
But now we're off topic because if we go back to it and say, is this right or wrong for him to put up? The mayor said he should take it down in good taste. The guy says he's not going to. The guy who complained in his neighborhood went over and apologized to him.
He probably didn't know.
For making this such a big ruckus, and he understands. That's where we are.
Okay, but I understand, and I do know that it has many different things, and it could just be as silly as, hey, I'm hanging a guy for Halloween. I get that, but the fact that there's not any other decor, and don't even start because it's true, that to me is the deciding factor of, this is weird. What are you trying to do here? Because, yes, we did have a body climbing out of a grave in our Halloween decorations on our front lawn, but it was a complete graveyard. Including, by the way, because you know Todd would go completely over the top, like with the old rusted wheelbarrow, and he even found decorative iron fencing he put around it. And then there was, of course, the lighting. He even
You got to go back. You got to go back to the original question: is it okay to have up or not? Period. And it doesn't matter about what the house looked like. It doesn't matter about anything.
But
is it okay for them to hang someone in a tree for Halloween? And I'm totally sensitive to the feeling, or if it brings that memory to you. Of hanging an African American, I totally understand that, and I'm just kind of questioning. To me, it's creepy too. It is, But to me, it's just like crawling out of a grave, okay. Hanging from a tree, not okay.
Yeah, but there's no...
I mean, God knows what would happen if we put him on a cross. Holy baloney.
What is wrong with you?
I don't know.
One would do that.
I know.
What is wrong with you?
I don't know. I just said that.
And there's no racist implication of a corpse crawling out of a grave, unless you hate The Walking Dead. And if you hate The Walking Dead, there's something wrong with you. It's the best show on cable television.
What's
wrong with you? Okay.
Rock.
But the point is this. I don't think.
What do you guys think?
If you get
Facebook.
Into the whole, yeah, please Facebook it. If you get into the whole snowflakey thing of, let's not do anything that would upset anyone, I get that. It's like, really get over it. My only indication, my only thought is, the fact this is your only decoration and you've got a dude hanging from a tree, and the original mask was black.
What if we go there today and there's more decorations up?
Then I will go up onto his door and I will knock and I will offer him a big bag of candy and say I'm sorry.
Guess where we're going after the show?
You gonna take another video with your finger over it?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
You know why? Because that identifies that as me because it has my fingerprint on the lens. They go, oh, remember Todd Collard's videos?
Tell us what you
with
think.
With the finger over the lens.
Well, MJ has a good argument. She goes, think about the kids walking by. What kind of a signal is that doing?
Mm-hmm.
Another person says it's a little extreme because I grew up in that time too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of... I just want to know what you think. If you can tell us on Facebook, I'm just curious.
Yeah, chime in. Then we're going to go see the other decorations that are up. Totally understand, by the way, if it bothers you. I totally get it.
If that were not the only decoration, I wouldn't be as weirded out by it. But there aren't any others now. I don't care what they put up now. Then it's different. That's fine. But as of this time, this
it's
is the
October
only thing I have to work with.
5th. And I know you start celebrating around August.
And I do. But that's not my point.
It's the 5th of October.
This is the only information we have to work on right now.
So why not just go off the deep end?
I'm not going off the deep end. I didn't even suggest anything. I said I'm not going to get all snowflakey about it. I'm just wondering.
Mm-hmm.
Fine, let's go to Daisy.
National Fiddler.
She's in the Gephardt Daily newsroom where she's apparently the only sane person in the studio.
Fight, and she's brought
to you by Fink and McGregor Mortgages Made Simple. You know you can get a mortgage with a credit score as low as 600. Go to fink-mcgregor.com for more information. Also by Columbus Travel. They are having a screamingly good cruise sale this month. And believe me, when I say screamingly good, Todd and I are already looking into booking something. This is the time to go. Go to columbusvacations.com. And by All Utah Plumbing, Heating, and Air. 24-hour emergency service because... when a pipe bursts, you want them to come right then. That's all UtahPlumbing.com. Daisy, my darling, what is going on this morning?
Good morning, Todd and Erin. Hello again, everyone. Here's a look at national and world news for Thursday, October 5th on GebhardtDaily.com. Mary Lou Danley, the girlfriend of Las Vegas mass shooter Stephen Paddock, says she knew nothing of his deadly plan, but Las Vegas Sheriff Joe Lombardo says he remains unconvinced. Danley told investigators when Paddock bought her a ticket to visit family in the Philippines and then wired $100,000 with instructions to buy them a house, she assumed he was breaking off their relationship. I knew Stephen Paddock as a kind, caring, quiet man, Danley's statement said. He never said anything to me or took any action that I was aware of that I understood in any way to be a warning that something horrible like this would happen. 3 U.S. Special Forces troops died and 2 others were injured Wednesday when they came under attack during a patrol in Niger. Unnamed military sources told the New York Times and CNN the 3 Army Green Berets died after coming under hostile fire. The incident happened during a joint patrol with U.S. and Nigerian forces in the southwest Niger. No word yet on the troops' identities. And now to a question front and center in Washington, D.C. Wednesday. Is Donald Trump a moron? According to NBC News, Secretary of State Rex Tillerson thinks so. NBC says a frustrated Tillerson called Mr. Trump moron during a staff meeting earlier this year. Tillerson isn't denying the claim, but has rebuffed rumors he's considering resigning during a hastily called press conference Wednesday. Trump called reports of Tillerson's alleged insolence fake news. That's it for now. For more headlines from across the country and around the world, go to GebhardtDaily.com.
Right. This is the new 97% efficient furnace that we put in, so we want to take care of it.
So if you do maintain it, how long will this last?
I believe if you do maintain it properly, I mean, it really uses specialty tools.
Right.
We're going to go over that. Anywhere from 18 to 25 years.
What? At high efficiency.
Right.
And it'll pay for itself almost,
completely. Right. It's bought your next unit by then. So this right here, we're checking through the vents for CO levels.
Right.
Carbon monoxide. If that shows me anything,
not good.
We got a problem.
All right, so where do you go? If that sets off, then you're going to go into the combustion chamber.
Huh?
That's right. You've been paying attention. And along with that, so then we use the computer analyzer. Mm-hmm. I like the back rack. Mm-hmm. At any rate, that goes into our combustion to measure the efficiency, how many parts per million of CO it's putting out.
Right.
And really tells us how the equipment's running. From there, we can adjust using this tool.
Right.
This will hook up to the gas valve. Now, this one's modulating, but many of them, you hook up to the gas valve, and you may have to adjust that to get it dialed in just right.
So you get the efficiency.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And then before we're cleaning, we'll get to that
one in a second. I love this one.
So it's running. Now I like to check my motors. How are they amping? Check through, are we getting proper power at places?
Right.
Things like that. Then the final thing is I shut it down and now we're gonna visually check.
Yeah, I love this thing. Look at this.
Our camera.
It's like a medical device.
Uh-huh. So we use
uncomfortable.
Yeah. Thank heavens the other one's smaller. At any rate. So we use our camera.
Right.
Here, have that.
Go ahead.
Now that is a quick check. Then the last thing we've got to really visually. So we'll sometimes go through the top. We'll pull the blower completely out, crawl in there and really check the chamber. And now at that point, we know that this thing is safe.
Right.
And it's adjusted for the winter to get through the whole winter. That doesn't mean maybe a problem couldn't happen. It can't. But it's safe. We know that you're, again, going to get through that winter.
Alive.
And it's going to be more efficient. And that we really like that.
All right.
So that's what we do.
This is the thing I think is funny. You got all this high-tech stuff.
How do you like my... Yes, this one. This is my most important tool. No, really. Actually, if the homeowner, you know, kind of whatever, you'd kind of dust things off. And yes, I do use cleaner on it.
That's crazy.
All right, get through it.
So you're going to do a good job. All right, so do you have an offer you'd like to throw out there?
We do. So what we're doing this for is $69 fee. We come out, we do everything we just talked about, check everything, make sure we're good. Along with those things, there's many others. There's airflow. There's lots of things that we didn't discuss, but we have other videos about. But $69, call for details. Based on maybe where you're at or when you want it done.
Right.
At any rate, just give us a call and we'll get right on it.
So just give them a call, right? All Utah Plumbing, Heating, your best friend, and air. John, thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
John is such a character, I'm telling you, but we seem
to
be...
what we're going to start doing with him?
What?
We're going to have him start reading stories to children on film. Everybody already knows about All Utah Plumbing, so now we're going to have them start reading stories to children. Special stories. You can have your children as part of it if you would like. We'll be telling you about it next week. Go on.
We have been spending a lot of time this summer looking towards the stars and the heavens.
This is true.
We had the eclipse. There's been some other events that have happened.
Crazy moons this year.
And now it's the biggie. Now it's the main event, my friends.
Yes.
It is the harvest moon.
I was out running last night looking at it.
The equinox.
Gorgeous.
And today is the day that it will happen. It'll look full for 2 days, by the way, so you know.
They called it the harvest moon because the light was so bright that they could actually still harvest crops on it, right? They could still go out even though it got darker and darker and the people could still harvest.
No, that's,
they could
see. That's bull. No, it's not.
Then why is it called the harvest moon?
I actually had a friend in Denver. Her name was CJ. And CJ came and went over to their house for coffee, her and her husband. And she goes, I got it done last night. So what'd you get done? She goes, I planted my garden. I said, you planted your garden last night? She goes, yeah. I was reading about it. And if you plant your garden by the harvest moon, she went out at night and planted her garden, the seeds.
Right before winter?
No, there's another one in the spring.
Oh, okay.
And planted them during the night. So anyway.
That still does not diminish my argument that this is the harvest moon because it was so bright last night I could see my shadow.
Yeah.
And I bet the farmers, when they did... wrong with you today?
Why would a farmer want to stay out at night?
Because he's desperate to finish harvesting his crops before the frost comes.
He and her should be inside making babies. Anyway, there's incredible...
Are you drinking this morning? No. I'm genuinely...
Why do you always ask me that?
Because I'm really beginning to question it.
Did I tell you to donate blood at the Red Cross again? I have some fascinating facts about the Harvest Moon that you need to know about, because if you don't know about it, no one will.
Okay.
I would like to share them with you.
Please do.
Stop with your thing. I want you to pay attention, because these are incredible. No. This year's Harvest Moon will officially start at 2:40 this afternoon. That's 4:40. Our time. All right, so 80 years, so we know that. 80 years between 1970 and 2015. Okay, that's not important. Next year will be back more than the unusual schedule that it... That's not good. Harvest moons can happen as early as September 8th. Okay, that... No. Sometimes the full moon happens when the equinox... It's according to new Native American tradition. Here you go. The calendar was marked by cycles of the moon, and thus each... Okay. The autumn... No. Okay. During the rest of the year, the moon rises up to a full 73 minutes later than... Okay. While all moons rise at sunset, the fact the harvest moon has a shorter rising lag... Okay, that's not good. The sunset occurrence is simply... makes a spectacular... No. And about the giant part, the harvest moon is like a moon poster child... the so-called moon illusion. Okay, eyes suggesting the relative terrestrial objects. And, okay, so that pretty much wraps that up. The harvest moon's today, and it's going to be big.
We'll be right back, and we're going to tell you more about bronies and why you should get off the old...
We're brought to you this morning by Executive Transportation. Elegant service, professional style. Go to executiveutah.com. And All Utah Plumbing. Your home deserves the best. 24-hour emergency service at allutahplumbing.com. Did you know you can catch the Todd and Erin morning stream any time of the day or night on Facebook, YouTube, and SoundCloud, and GephardDaily.com?
All right. What are we doing here?
Mountain lion.
Oh, the mountain
fishermen,
yeah.
Minding their own business. Flaming Gorge.
Flaming Gorge. Hang on.
Utah fishermen going.
Okay, so would you stop? You just gave the whole thing away now.
Do you want me to finish the show by myself?
Well, you're going to have to at this point. Two fishermen are out in boats, and then a mountain lion swam between them. Here's the picture. Ta-da. Swam to the other side of the lake.
I didn't know mountain lions could swim. Cats traditionally do not like water. Can mountain lions swim?
Another myth.
I had no idea they could do that.
Mm-hmm. Have you donated blood yet? I want to get back to that. All right. What else do you got? Get off my lawn.
You know, the cranky old thing about how we complain about children, and basically it's the millennials now, how we all mock the millennials, and they're like, we didn't do anything. We're just sitting here. Well... this is pretty much has a historical basis.
This really does have a history. You know, if you ever find yourself doing the old person thing about get off my lawn or those kids, you know, and you start doing that, you have to slap yourself because you don't want to become one of those things. I'm going to let you read something that was just put out. And this is from this year. Just read that one there.
The tragic truth is that America's millennials are a bunch of phone-addicted, selfie-obsessed, hashtagging, Snapchatting, kale-munching, twerking, lazy, whining, ill-informed, politically correct, cosseted narcissists who find absolutely everything mortally offensive and believe that there are 165 ways to sexually identify.
2017.
Wow. You really hate him.
1771. The year, 1771.
Whither are manly vigor and athletic appearance of our forefathers flown? Can these be their legitimate heirs? Surely no. A race of effeminate, self-admiring, emaciating fribbles can never have descended in a direct line from the heroes of Agincourt.
See?
You're absolutely
it
right.
It never changes.
That's really sad. 300 years earlier and we still...
I still don't understand what we're picking on.
Although I do like the word fribble and I think it should be brought back into the modern lexicon immediately.
It probably should.
Self-absorbed fribbles.
You know, it might be just the 5th of October, but Oktoberfest in Germany has already happened.
That's a shame. That was quick.
Well, it was a great time, had by all. Here's some facts about Oktoberfest. After 18 days.
Yes.
It's the 184th. They had 6.2 million partygoers.
You really like beer in Germany.
Really do. They talked about all the things and all the fun everybody had. And then here's the lost and found. So let's remember, 6.2 million people
drinking beer.
Steins of beer. Never enough porta potties. 217 children were fed or got their diapers changed in a room that was the child care offices at Oktoberfest. How many? 217. Oktoberfest lost and found. Remember, big steins of beer. 4,000 items were found.
Okay. Wow.
Among them, 1,300 passports.
Dude, you need those. You use those.
620 pieces of personal clothing.
That doesn't surprise me.
600.
Is it hot in here? Is it me?
600 wallets, 525 cell phones, smartphones, 360 keys. That's probably safe. That's probably a good thing at a beer fest not to have car keys.
So far, I would be making a buttload of money off of this stuff. Keep
right?
going.
100 bags or rucksacks, a pair of crutches.
What, rucksacks?
Rucksacks. That's what Germans use. It's European. Rucks.
You mean like a backpack?
You've never heard of the term rucksack?
No.
She has such a
I
sheltered life.
I have my rucksack.
That's right.
Okay. Go on. What else?
Right? You know what I'm... Yeah. Donate blood. 15 cameras also found as a set of dentures, a pair of crutches, number plate, which is a license plate.
License plate.
A drinking horn, a pair of leather pants.
You know you're going to miss those.
You know, it's one thing just to wear leather pants because it's awesome, but the other thing is to take them off. That's crazy. You don't. I'm not sure you want to do that.
I know this is really sick and I'm a bad person, but I keep thinking of all the money I could make. All those wallets, those cell phones, expensive items. That's awesome.
Well, why don't you just cut out the middleman and go steal it from them while they're
just,
drinking?
They'll just leave it there and stagger off. I can just stop by afterwards and pick it up.
All right, so you have a story about a time traveler.
Well, I've heard a lot of excuses for this particular violation, but this is a good one. There's a Casper man.
Casper.
Who people started, this Wyoming, residents started calling police going, I don't know about this guy. Could you come and just check out what that you're doing?
Right.
So Casper police officers went down. They found Brian Johnson.
Hi, Brian.
Who claimed he was from the year 2048 and
what?
Was trying to warn the people of Casper that aliens were coming next year and they should leave as soon as possible. And then he said, I need to talk to the president of the town.
Because?
He wanted to warn them about the aliens coming in 2018.
So he's breaking into?
And he said, the only way I'm able to time travel is have aliens fill my body with alcohol and then stand at a giant pad which transports me to 2017. But he said, they got me wrong because I was supposed to be in 2018 right before they arrived so I could warn everybody. Casper police also noticed that he had watery bloodshot eyes. He was slurred and there was a strong smell of alcohol coming.
That's what happens when you travel through time and space.
Yeah, Brian, had his body filled with alcohol so he could stand with jet pad and be transported back.
You've been drinking this morning?
No. But the nice thing is it was determined that he could not take care of himself and ended up causing a disturbance in the emergency room, which is how he ended up in jail. Now, here's the funny part.
May I?
Yes.
So we called the jail so we could use the picture, because that's what you have to do. It's called protocol. And I want you guys in the back room to turn it up a little bit so we can share in this. So we called, and they weren't there, so they put us, so it went to the message, and I did not know this, but you can leave a message for, listen to this.
Thank you for calling the Natrona County Inmate Information System. If this is an emergency, hang up and dial 911 now. Leave a personal voicemail for your incarcerated loved one for only $1.99 using jail voicemail. Say voicemail or press 1. jail voicemail. To skip the introduction and go straight to recording a message, say skip or press star. You will now be able to use your credit card to leave a message for an inmate. The cost of this voicemail is
$1.99.
And the voicemail must be
45
seconds or less.
That would be horrible.
You can talk to your incarcerated loved ones.
I think that's so cool. But there's no sex chat because it's 45. Well, if you've been locked up for that. So anyway, I know what mine would be.
I just love the fact that she did that entire message with a straight face. For $1.99, you can talk to your incarcerated loved ones for a full 45 seconds.
You know what mine would be like? Mine would be like, Rocky, where'd you hide the drugs and the booze? Where is it? Where's the drugs? Like that, because you'd want to know, because he's in prison and you're not. And he hid the money and the drugs someplace, so you would want it back.
You've been watching too many old 50s gangster movies. I would like to introduce you to the Bronies. I heard about them a few years ago at one of the comic cons I was covering. Because these guys came up, and number one, they were two fully dressed like My Little Ponies. And I went, that's a great costume. Did you get that from your kid from Halloween? And he was furious. And he said, no, My Little Pony is not for children. And I went, well, okay. See, the Bronies are the adult males who call themselves Bronies. They're not overly effeminate. Many aren't gay. They're just dudes. They're just your standard dude who likes My Little Pony. Now, when I say they like it, I mean they have conventions that are 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 strong,
right,
of just Bronies, where they come to celebrate all things My Little Pony.
And they do, and they bring celebrities on, like the people who do voices. Shall we watch?
Yes.
All right, let's watch.
You ain't a man unless you watch My Little Pony, son.
I'm Ashley Ball, and I am the voice actor in Vancouver. I do the voices of Applejack and Rainbow Dash on the new My Little Pony series.
I happen to be the fastest Pegasus in the sky. It's because I'm awesome.
I've just been invited to go to the 2012 BronyCon in New York City.
The pervert alarm for sure went off in my head when I first heard about it.
Bronies are these young adults. They're looking for connections with other people. They need to find something to sort of give them meaning.
So this is definitely blowing me away.
Forget you, I can eat all these apples.
I am a Brony.
All they are people who like a cartoon show. That's it.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I love this. I don't care. I'm sorry, I love it. And did you see those actresses? They're so adorable because they look genuinely shocked.
They look frightened.
They're on the panel, and everyone's like doing all the moves and singing and stuff with them. I love them.
It's just frightening. You guys have a great day. It's the Todd and Erin morning stream at GetBartDaily.com.
You go, Bronies. I love you.
It's a really important part of a lot of these people's lives. So, yeah, as long as, like, My Little Ponies exist, there will be Bronies.